Certification is a first step towards a professional success. It will help you to learn in depth and also verifies your knowledge on that subject. In this highly competitive time, a certified professional is in a great demand. Hey guys, I'm Charul from Intellipaat, and in today's video, we are going to discuss AWS DevOps Certification. So before proceeding further with today's video, do like this video and also subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss out any of our updates and our next video. Without wasting more time in this, let's have a look to our agenda. First and foremost, we are going to discuss why do we need DevOps, and then we will see what exactly is DevOps, and then we will understand what is AWS. If we combine them together, we will understand what is AWS DevOps and why AWS is suitable for DevOps, followed by types of AWS certification, and then what is AWS DevOps certification, and what is the eligibility for AWS DevOps, and what exam expects from you, and how to prepare, and what Intellipaat offers you. And finally, there would be a quiz to recap whatever you have learned in today's session. So put down your answer in the comment section below so that you will get to know if you have answered correctly. Let's begin this session.
First, we will go through why DevOps. Let's talk about what happened in an organization before DevOps came. There were basically two divisions. One was the development team and one more was the operations team. The development team worked on the software, developing it and making sure that the code worked perfectly. After that, the code is released and executed by the operations team, which is responsible for the release and the operations of that code. The operations team will be checking the application and its performance. As the development team worked on programming, debugging, analysis and many more, and the operations team worked on the release and the executions of that code. You might have figured that the deployment wasn't a very smooth process, and during that time the team faced many issues in execution and deployment, thereby making it a long and a tedious process. Now let us move forward. So what is DevOps? Let's talk what is DevOps and how it combines both of the cycles. Here is a Wikipedia definition of DevOps. DevOps is a set of software development practices which combines software development as well as the information technology operations to shorten the system's development lifecycle while delivering its features, fixes, and updates frequently in close alignment with the business objectives. Now let's see this in an easier perspective. DevOps is not a tool or a team. It's a process or a methodology of using various tools to solve different kinds of problems between developers and the operations team. Hence, the term DevOps. It's a continuous running process where continuous development, testing, and integration, deployment, as well as monitoring is also done. Now, let us understand what is AWS. It stands for Amazon Web Service, and it is a platform which helps businesses scale and grow by offering the secure cloud services like compute power, database storage, content delivery, and many more. Now, let us discuss what is AWS DevOps. AWS offers you a platform to perform DevOps. Let's have a look at the definition first. AWS provides services that help you practice DevOps. These tools will help in automating the manual tasks, helps team manage complex environments at a scale, and keep the engineers in control of the high velocity, which is enabled by DevOps. Now, you must be wondering, what does AWS offer that makes it suitable for DevOps? That we shall discuss later as we move forward. Here, no setup is required or software to install it. With AWS, purchase services are based on pay-as-you-go, and it is only for the period when you plan to use them. You can also manage from a single instance to that of thousands using AWS services. AWS will also help you use automation so that you can build it in a faster and in an efficient way. It is highly secure and it uses AWS to set the user permissions and policies. And you also have an option to use each service via the AWS command line interface or through APIs and SDKs. Keeping this in mind, now let us understand what exactly is an AWS certification. This certification is a level of Amazon Web Services cloud expertise that an IT professional obtains after passing one or more exams that Amazon offers. It is basically to demonstrate and validate the technical cloud knowledge and skills one has obtained. AWS also provides different certification exams like AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner, AWS Certified Developer, AWS Certified Solutions Architect, AWS Certified SysOps Administrator, and many more. Moving on, now we will see types of AWS certifications. AWS offers certifications mainly on Foundation, Associate, Professional, and Specialty levels, and all the certifications follow the hierarchy in these levels. By seeing the above figure, you must have figured out that AWS DevOps comes under the professional level certification exam, and this is what we are discussing, right? Now, let us quickly understand what is AWS DevOps certification. So, this certification, that is AWS Certified DevOps Engineer, comes under the professional level exam, and it is intended for the individuals possessing technical skills required for DevOps engineer with 2+ years of experience in provisioning, operating, and managing the large-scale distributed application on the AWS platform. Moving further, we will have a check on the eligibility to take this exam. As we discussed earlier, this exam is for the DevOps engineer role with 2+ years of experience of working with AWS environment. Since it is a professional certification, hence you need an associate level certification. Under the umbrella of things you should know beforehand, we have certain prerequisites as working knowledge of AWS and DevOps, clarity on what AWS development is, familiarity with high-level programming languages like Java, Python, JavaScript, and so on. You need to have the knowledge to administer Linux or Windows at the command line, and also work experience with AWS Management Console and AWS command line interface is must ensure. Through what you can skill up from, we will have a look at this. Since this is a professional certification, if you are from any of these professional backgrounds, then going for AWS DevOps certification is an added advantage. Since you are already familiar with the skill set, some of the professional backgrounds are as follows. Maybe a system architect, software tester, security engineer, DevOps engineer, system administrator, application developers, and integration specialist, and many more. Everyone will be eager to know the exam pattern because it helps everyone in preparing for something better, right? So, every exam follows a pattern, and to be fully prepared for the exam, you should be familiar with these. Let us discuss about it. The exam consists of multiple choice questions or multiple answer questions depending on the need of a question, and this exam comes under the professional level certification. You will get around 170 minutes of time to complete this examination. The pricing depends on which location you are taking your exam from. For example, if you are taking your exam in US, then it's going to cost you around $300. But if you are taking it in India, then you will have to pay an amount of 20,258 Indian rupees. This exam is not just constrained to English language, but it is also available in Japanese, Korean, and Chinese languages. In order to be well prepared for AWS DevOps certification exam, you must know what are the expectations for the exam, right? So, AWS DevOps certification basically tests your knowledge on how to implement methodology in Amazon Web Services and how to execute and computerize security controls, governance processes, and compliance validation. Also, you should be able to define and deploy monitoring, metrics, and logging systems on AWS. You should be able to implement systems that are highly available, scalable, and self-healing on the AWS platform. You must know how to design, manage, and maintain tools in order to automate operational processes. Now, we will see how to prepare thoroughly for this exam. The first step is to plan the module structure and study accordingly. For example, if you are going to implement a CI/CD pipeline on AWS, then you must know how to configure your EC2 instance and how does an AWS code pipeline helps you automate steps in your software delivery process, such as initiating automatic builds and then deploying it to the Amazon EC2 instances. You should be thorough with the AWS code pipeline, which consists of source storage parts like AWS S3 and code commit, and how does a deployment takes place in AWS code deploy from a beta stage to that of the production stage, right? You would require a lot of questions and verified study materials to earn good passing scores. Learn about technology and refer to many websites. You can refer to the official curriculum and study guide to plan your module study and get the right information. After that, practice sample test online. Once you have gained enough knowledge with this, then you should be able to step up into the next part of practicing hands-on, and this is the most crucial part in your learning journey. You can easily perform hands-on in AWS Management Console since AWS provides majority of its services under free trial eligibility with multiple types of limits. Even with the limits, free trial is quite suitable for small application deployments as well as for learning processes. Practicing hands-on will not only help you in cracking the exam, but it will also get you ready for your future job role. In addition to that, check for an online training so that in case you have queries related to the subject, you can clear them right away, and experts' help is always recommended. Last but not least, join the forums related to AWS DevOps and search for questions related to your subject and check out the questions asked by other people and go through the answers posted by the audience itself. It will always be helpful for you. Last suggestion from my end is that go for dumps only when you are thorough with the subject. You might be able to clear the exam and get certification from it, but believe me, you won't be job ready as during the interview. Without the practical approach, you won't be able to crack it or able to answer the questions by the interviewer because you took the shortcut to get certified. So, beware of the shortcuts, do a thorough study with the proper implementations in AWS DevOps and rise up in your career path. Now, you might be wondering how to take time for all this research and study. That is why we at Intellipaat are here for you. We understand that you as a professionals face problems to take time out from skilling up from your personal life. That's why we have done all the hard work for you and have come up with a comprehensive course on AWS DevOps Certification exam. Moving forward, so now let's discuss what Intellipaat offers you. In this AWS DevOps training, the curriculum followed by Intellipaat is as follows. You will learn about all automation process in the software development lifecycle with configuration management and infrastructure as a core. You will be exhaustively introduced to monitoring and logging concepts and about policies and standard automation. You will also get to know about the incident and the event response. Last but not the least is the fault tolerance and the disaster recovery. And the best thing about this course is you will work on industry-oriented case studies based on every major AWS service, and by the end of your module, you will also get to work on 2 to 3 individual projects and a capstone project. Now, I have a question for you. Which one of them is recommended experience to go for an AWS DevOps engineer role? Options are hands-on with EC2 instance, on-premises servers and managing them. Next, experience in designing and building large-scale applications. Ability to build CI/CD pipelines, or all of the above.
So, This brings us to the end of this session. If you have any queries, do comment below and we will reach out to you immediately. And also, do subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss out any of our upcoming videos. I hope this video was helpful for you. See you again.